Oh well, if you watched my last video, you'd know that we had a slight problem with the battery charger. That problem has been now resolved. Of course, this is the old charger. Nice bit of kit, but it's got an internal fault. So it's got to go. Because the solution is a Numax battery charger. The only problem with the Numax is that I can't leave it attached all the time. I can only have it attached if there's power going to the charger to charge the batteries. That's the new charger, a lot smaller than the old one, but it does a lot less as well. So tonight's job is put that in there. Still working on the electric cupboard. We'll look inside. Today I think I'll put the floor back in. Obviously the large battery charger's gone and the new one is tucked down here. It's gonna stay loose because it doesn't got no brackets on it to fix it to anything. And I'll only be using it campsites, so it's not just a bad thing. Today now I'm going to carry on with the electrics. I made a start. You can see just having the backs of two sockets. And if we go to this side, I've actually got the two sockets in. I've now got to put a small 12 volt socket in. There'll be a 12 volt socket going in the back of the van. There's going to be a panel on that frame so that when the missus is playing with a phone in bed, she can charge the phone at the same time. So the next stage now is to get two plugs, two sockets in here. So that's going to be I'll be drilling a hole in each one and then sewing it out square. So that's my job for the next quarter hour. Well, I've just cut the two holes in the unit. Wasn't the easiest of jobs. Yeah, wasn't easy at all. Not because cutting the wood was hard, but I had an accident. And the side of my glasses fell off. So now I've got to crawl around the van and find a little screw and screw them back together. Oh, it's hard life. We've got the plugs in now. If we take a close up of those, this plug on the left is a standard 240 volt twin plug. It's got two USB ports on it. This plug is just a standard 240 volt unit. This one runs off the inverter. This one runs off shore power. That's why the USB chargers are on it. That way, if I'm not hooked up to shore power, I can use the inverter for this one. There's no point in using the inverter to drop back down to 12 volt. So for any 12 volt system, I'll just use the normal plugs. Now, does it work? This is the control for the inverter. If I just press this blue button, the inverter is now on. Right, I've plugged in my saw, electric saw, which up till now I've been using off my daughter's 240 volt shore power. So this is the test. That is blinking brilliant. I could have sworn then, but I didn't. That was really is. I'm impressed with that. So let's get on with the rest of the wiring. Well, it's been a busy old day for me because I've now got the electric box in for the main shore power. So that's all that's left now is to put the cover on and hook up all the wires in the right places so they're not trailing or being snagged by anyone. That's not a bad Sunday's work, is it? Right, the electrics are in. This is the shore power. That's the inverter. Both of them have been checked and they're working a treat. This black box here is to run the fridge. It's an automatic thing. It runs off the 12 volt and shore power. If you're connected to shore power, that's how the fridge is run. But there's no messing around with fiddly switches. The cables have all been put out of the way. That's where the shore power comes in. All the cables have been pegged up there. And of course, that's the two back sockets. One is shore power and the other is inverter. Next on my list to do, there's a number of cables, red, black and red, hanging down from the switch box. I've now got to run them out to the bottom of the battery box, which is under here. And that's going to be my my 12 volt system. So that's going to keep me occupied for the next hour or two. That's another productive morning. Sorting out the electric box. And I think that's about it now. I've got 240 volt shore power, the inverter, just put in the 12 volt electric system. Well, the system as it is with this covered. That is now the plug for the battery charger, which is hidden away under there. These are the 12 volt wires. There's two wires in each black cover. So I've got 8 12 volt systems coming down out of the back at the bottom of the battery box where they'll connect up with the systems in the van. And of course, this is the inverter. There we have the backs of two of the plugs. One of them, this one is the inverter plug. And this one is the shore power. It's a bit of a mess of wires up under there, but that's what it is. Most things are covered up. I can now use this area for dry storage. So it's coming along nicely. Got to try and tomorrow I'm going to spend the day cleaning up this mess to see exactly where I am. There we are. That's the water tanks. That'll be the position for the gas tank. I have to drill a hole in the outside of the van to get the inlet sorted. And also a hole in the bottom of the van for a drop outlet for any gas that escapes. The fridge, the toilet, the messy bed. But I'll sort that out tomorrow. I think things are coming on quite nicely. I cleaned the van up. I made a mess again. However, I've been playing with electrics. Most of those are working. I haven't connected them all up, but I got most things working. Right, you can see now with the fridge, that 12 volt is working. That's one of these switches here. Right, that's the switch on off, which is brilliant. Right, I've got the fan working, that works off the switch but there. I don't know if you can hear it whizzing around, certainly can't see it, but that's working nice. Now, these lights here, and at the van, they are the old ambulance lights. So what I'll do, I'll knock those off now and show you my new LEDs. Right, that's my lights off, my lights on. These are the Chinese LED strip lights. If you buy them, be aware that the M3 tape on the back isn't the strongest. And what I've had to use is stick oil to get them to stick up. The good thing is I can change the colour. Which itself is good fun. I love the blue. You know, I can change colour to anything I want. Yeah, when it's working. But that's the colour, it is blue. But the fun part is, you're going to have to excuse this now because I have to turn the radio on. Right, excuse radio 2, but watch this now.
These are things that you can say, Joe, and these are things that I know.
That's the different sounds from the radio. You left with no warning and took the summer from my life. I gave you my That's going to really drive my missus nuts. So that's about it for now. Gonna have to wrap up this video and start the next one. So I'll see you soon. Oh well, here we are again. It's the end of episode 11.
Doesn't time fly when you're enjoying yourself?
And what are we doing episode 11?
I have no idea.
We did them. We solved the problem with the battery charger.
Yes.
Yeah, we replaced it.
Yes, you did.
We got the electrics. The electrics are coming on quite well now because we've got the fridge working, the new LED lights. We've
got the bed.
That's not electric.
No, I know that, but I'm just throwing it in like.
Yeah, with the bed's there, yeah.
As well.
It was until you had to pick it all up and start again. In that, I started cutting things again and made a mess. Oh, we cleaned the van and made a mess of it again.
I cleaned the van.
Good to be in there. So it's going all right, isn't it?
It's going lovely. Yeah. It's really taking shape now, isn't it? It's surprising how much space is in there as well, really.
It's really good. So, where are we today?
We're at Caerphilly Castle.
Caerphilly Castle. There's a man walking down here with a prow and the geese are chasing him.
Yeah.
Look. They're coming this way or are they going to carry on? There's geese everywhere. There's loads of... Look, I can see 4, 7...
Oh, look, they're coming down.
There's about 15 of them wandering down there.
Yeah. But you couldn't get them in.
No, we don't want the geese. So we're at Caerphilly Castle, which was built by the...
Normans.
The Normans. But what I can work out, it was like 300 years after they'd invaded England.
It was 200 and something, wasn't it?
Well, 298, wasn't it? Yeah. So it's a lovely castle, so anybody who's watching who's not from Wales, or this part of Wales, it's well worth coming here just to see the castle in Caerphilly.
And didn't we read that after the Normans built the castle, 2 years later it was blown up or destroyed?
Destroyed.
And the year after it was rebuilt?
It was destroyed by some Welsh hooligans who probably came in and thought we didn't want that year. And actually, a lot of the castle's missing. It's been rebuilt over the years. Did they say the Marquis of Bute actually invested a lot of money into rebuilding it? But unfortunately, years before that, the Caerphilly people pinched all the stone to build their houses. It's absolutely mad, because a lot of the houses around here are built out of the castle stone. Perhaps we should have a campaign and knock their houses down and rebuild the castle. It'd be more use to us, wouldn't it? A castle.
This is an unusual part that we're not the normal part of viewing, isn't it?
What do you mean?
Well, I've never been down with this actual little bit.
Oh yeah, this is the walk through the park. It's lovely.
I think I could walk through the park.
And there's a nice pub just up there, which we might visit later. I don't know.
Oh, is that the not the courthouse, is it?
It could be the courthouse. Yeah. So here we are. The end of episode 11, and it's been good so far. It's going to get slower now because the weather's horrible, and as I'm outdoors doing the van, I don't really feel like finishing work and going down and working in the dark and the cold and the wet. so it's going to be a bit slower.
I know.
We've got a fair bit to go. We've done a lot, but a fair bit to go. We've got a... I'm halfway through doing the electrics, and I'm planning on other things, putting cables in for the future.
Got the lights in.
The lights are lovely, yeah. Mm. Lights.
Disco lights.
Yeah. They're really good, yeah. There's lots of little things. We have to decide whether we're going to put a TV in there. 12-volt TV.
Well, you've got your laptop, haven't you?
Got the laptop. A radio in the back.
Dab radio.
A dab radio, yeah, so we can get Planet Rock.
Yay.
Planet Rock.
Rock
yeah.
on Tommy.
Because the rest of it's rubbish. I have to be fair. I'm not really into this pop music. I was once, but I was a child. I must have been about 8.
So, I like all kinds of music,
I know,
really.
Yeah, you do. You're a softie, yeah. So that's it. That's the end of episode 11. Right, we're going to do episode 12 next, but it's going to be a bit slower.
I think we'll go for a little coffee now.
We'll go for coffee now, yeah. Mm. So what are the words?
Magic!
Bye, everybody. Bye.
Bye, everybody.
You little bugger. I'm going to pan round now and show them the castle.
Yeah, yeah.
And we're going to pan round, yeah, slowly, just to see these people filming. I don't know what they're filming, but they're seem mad filming in this weather. And that's the castle from this angle. It's a lovely thing. I've just been told I have to get Tiny into the picture.
Tiny.
Tiny. Have you? Oh, yeah. Wave. Little dog. And that's it. End of the history lesson. Magic ball. Magic ball.